said, one shot, one opportunity to seize everything you ever wanted. One moment that you capture, just let it slip. Yo.
You better lose yourself in the music the moment you own it. You better never let it go. You only get one shot. Do not miss your chance to blow. This opportunity comes once in a lifetime. You better lose yourself in the music the moment you own it. You better never let it go. You only get one shot. Do not miss your chance to blow. This opportunity comes once in a lifetime.
From legendary Rupp Arena in Lexington, Kentucky, it's NCAA basketball on CBS today. One of the great rivalries in the country. It's Louisville versus the number one Wildcats. Hi, everybody. I'm Gus Johnson along with my partner, Billy Packer, and welcome to basketball country. Billy, the state of Kentucky is known for championships.
Well, they really are. Two great programs. We can see that they've won multiple national championships. Denny Crum took them to two, and of course, multiple coaches have taken Kentucky to seven national championships, 13 Final Fours.
For Louisville today, we get a chance to see a dynamic sophomore in Francisco Garcia.
He is a great scorer, but this year he's had three games with eight assists. A tremendous all-around player, great perimeter shooter, rebounder, shot blocker, one of the best in the country, Gus. And Kentucky has a young man that in the low post is as hard to get guard as anybody in the country, Eric Daniels. He's got both the left and the right hand inside. Very difficult in this very complex, great teamwork type offense that Kentucky runs.
And now let's find today's singular keys to the game, fan in the stands.
Hi, Billy. I'm Katie Martin, and I love my Kentucky. Wildcats, what are the keys to today's game?
Well, we really know how to pick those fans. Let's take a look at the keys of this game. Rick Pitino is 17-1 against former assistants or players. That spells well for Rick. The dean of the threes, Rick Pitino has always coached the three-point game very well, but Tubby Smith defends the perimeter as well as anybody in the country. And then the 27 wins and counting. Kentucky's last loss in regular season was against this Louisville club. Let's see if that streak continues today.
Make sure you vote. Coming up, it's Louisville against Kentucky on CBS.
Now you have a chance to win your own camera phone or a trip to the CBS regular season college basketball game of your choice. Vote now for the most important key to the game on your singular wireless phone. Text your answer to short code 225 or go to cbssportsline.com. Watch Singular at the half for the results.
3,000 strong here at Rupp Arena in Lexington. We're ready for Louisville and number one ranked Kentucky. Rick Pitino spent 8 years as the head coach at Kentucky, won a national championship. He's in his third season at Louisville. His team coming off a 107-56 win over VMI on Tuesday. The lineup, keep your eye on Garcia, the young man from the Bronx. He can really put the ball in the basket. And in the backcourt, Tyquan Dean from Neptune, New Jersey, also a very good scorer at 14 per game. Orlando Tubby Smith on the other sideline in his seventh season. He's won a national championship at Kentucky, and his team comes in with a perfect 7-0 record. Eric Daniels, one forward, Chuck Hayes the other, and in the backcourt, it's Azubuike, Hawkins, and Gerald Fitch, their leading scorer, close to 20. Gus Johnson, Billy Packer from legendary Rupp Arena. As you take a look at your officials, Billy, what should we pay attention to early on in this game?
Well, I think early in this ball game, you look for the outside shooting of Louisville and how does Kentucky defend it. Terrific individual matchups in this game as far as size is concerned. Right here, Dean and Hawkins, that should be as good a backcourt point guard matchup as you'll see in the college game.
Here comes Tyquan Dean along with Whitehead. Kentucky showing some early pressure.
Yeah, they really are pressuring all players outside on the perimeter. Louisville is going to have to get the ball down inside and then be able to kick back out.
Garcia from deep, it's short, rebounded by Dean, and they get a new shot clock.
Got to get dribble penetration inside or get the ball inside, and there's a great matchup. Hayes and Whitehead physically, they match each other up in size and power.
That one going over the backboard, so Kentucky will get it. Kentucky 7-0 coming off a 101-72 win over Eastern Kentucky. And what do you like about their team?
Well, what you like about it is the word team. Gus, I don't think this is as talented as some Kentucky's great basketball teams, but boy, they really play together. They understand how to distribute the ball. There's no selfishness whatsoever. Every guy really busted both on the offensive and defensive end. That's what they are. They are a team. Fun to watch. Louisville starts out in a little bit of a zone here. 2-3.
Kentucky has been shooting extremely well over the last three games, 60% from the field. Here's Daniels.
They've been getting a lot of those points inside in the paint. With this zone, that may be a problem.
And Hawkins knocks down the three.
They had Daniels with superior size, got out on him. Hawkins still got the shot over the top.
Cliff Hawkins, the sixth man last year, worked on his outside shot during the offseason and is shooting it better, 50% from the field. D'Artes to the basket.
And we talked about dribble penetration, but I didn't think we'd see it from D'Artes right off the bat. They played with nobody in the low post on that offensive set. And they stay in the 2-3 matching up zone here.
Here's Fitch.
Double team with the long arms of D'Artes and Garcia. Here we're going to see dribble penetration. D'Artes shocked Kentucky by going around. Daniels taking all the way to the hole and a tremendous finish on the dunk. No opportunity to block.
And Fitch inbounding on the baseline. We had a chance to see Kentucky yesterday on working, when they work rather on splitting the double team when they are double team and making the best pass possible.
And when that ball goes down the baseline with those long arm Louisville players, you can really be in trouble if you get double team. Hawkins with another jumper.
Straight away, loose ball tapped around. Daniels with the rebound as Abuki changed his shot in midair. And D'Artes rips it down.
Nice interior passing, but maybe one pass too many as Hayes did a nice job tapping that ball out to Daniels. Daniels probably should have put the shot up.
Here's Garcia looking for Whitehead, posting up.
Yeah, he wants it down there against Hayes. This is a real good matchup.
Good defense by Hayes.
Tremendous.
And Louisville this season with some success against number one teams.
Well, they really have. And we can see number one has been beaten this year. Connecticut, Kansas, Florida, and Florida.
First half of play, Kentucky up 3-2.
Gus, one of the things we're going to see out here today is a lot of screening from Kentucky. They do a terrific job in screening, and then the screener becomes the offensive factor. We're going to see right here Hayes, Daniels, all of them can handle this very well from the top of the screen. And everybody gets out of the way to create a terrific pass for the lob over the top after the screen is set. You really have to jump out and hedge. There's a weak hedge move. Here we see the screen ball going right over the top. Hawkins to Hayes, easy two. That's why Kentucky's been so effective inside, not because they have any giant postman, because they pass so well in the interior.
Kentucky with the early lead, great crowd on hand, sellout, over 23,000 in attendance. Both teams start the game 1-3 as Louisville gets back into that zone. In the corner, Azapuki, who's been on fire from downtown this year.
D'Artes late getting out there. Azubuki, with the exception of the Michigan State game, really has been on fire. A very solid offensive score.
He is 13 of 17 from the three-point line this year.
Look at Hayes is kind of smiling at Whitehead, saying, you know what? You bring me out of the post, I can guard you out here as well.
Tyquan Dean fadeaway jump shot. Rebounded by Hayes. Here come the Wildcats on the run. Fitch steps into a three. Rebounded. Hayes and
two hands. Was that, Gus? A two-handed rebound over bigger people, D'Artes, Daniels, and Whitehead.
Timeout Louisville. 16:53 remaining in the first half. Kentucky up 8-2.
Well, Gus, without question, the ultimate report card in college basketball is what do you do in the NCAA tournament? Here we see Izzo, Mike Krzyzewski, Rick Pitino, Tubby Smith, right here in the 3 and the 5 position. Both have done it over the test of time. Tubby at both Georgia and obviously here at Kentucky. Rick has had a tremendous record. Providence took to a Final Four. What he's done at Kentucky, and you have to assume one of these days you'll have Louisville in the Final Four as well.
Tubby Smith also successful at Tulsa. Here's Garcia now. Stop and start to the basket, deals down low, Whitehead stripped away.
There's Hayes again
in the front court. Daniels all alone.
Bad defensive balance that time by Louisville. Terrific hit ahead by Kentucky. They are really playing some excellent defense in the half court right now and have taken Louisville completely out of their offensive set.
Kentucky on a 10-2 run. Tyquan Dean down the lane. Whitehead rejected. He gets it back. Rejected.
And we're talking about a Louisville team that is a shot-blocking ball club. Kentucky, not a shot-blocking ball club until the Indiana game. It's three in a row.
Azabuki on the baseline again. And Rick Pitino and the Louisville Cardinals have to find a way to stop the bleeding.
Now, Louisville was down 11 in the first half of last year's ball game, came back to win it 81-63. But they're facing a really outstanding Kentucky team right now.
Inside, D'Artes leans in, stripped away again.
That was Hawkins that got the strip on the way up.
Cliff, nice pass inside. Little too low, though, for Daniels.
Daniels probably would have caught that. He's got good hands inside, just took his eyes off. There's one block. Lack of floor balance really costs Louisville here. Now watch what happens as the ball goes in and gets to Hawkins' hands. All the Louisville players will be in here. Allows Daniels to take off long for an easy basket. No floor balance, and there goes Daniels, and of course Hawkins looking ahead with his head up on that dribble, makes the perfect delivery.
Cliff Hawkins leads the SEC in assists, averaging close to 7 per game. He's second in the conference in steals. Here come the Louisville Cardinals, scoreless over the last 3 minutes.
And Dean hasn't been able to get any good looks from three, coming off that record-setting performance, setting new records at Louisville.
Larry O'Bannon in the game. Here's Dean. Too strong. Chuck Hayes with another rebound.
Maybe a little, put it up a little bit too quick there, but did get an open look.
Hayes with three rebounds early on. Daniels wraps it around right out of bounds.
Not a bad idea, and you can see what great interior passing. This team is completely unselfish.
And Billy, you talked about Louisville defeating Kentucky last year at Freedom Hall, 81-63 in December, and that's a loss that these Wildcats remember very well.
Well, they went from that point on until the Marquette game, beating everybody in their way, got themselves the number one position in the country.
Nice post move by Otis George.
What Louisville has got to do, create a presence inside to force Kentucky to help out inside and give up some of that perimeter shooting. Right now, the Kentucky defense is just so tight on the perimeter outside shooters. Nice step out by George.
Hawkins picks up his dribble. Hayes hard down the lane, throws it out of bounds. And it's last up by the Cardinals.
Break for Kentucky there. That was not a good pass. Too many people down inside on Daniels.
Chuck Hayes, what a rugged player. Has soft hands, great passer. Also, a terrific body. Leading rebounder on this team. Eight on the shot clock. Fitch quiet so far in the corner. Wide open Azabuki. Loose ball tapped around. Batted out by Daniels to Fitch. Daniels with another rebound. Oh. Saves it again. Fitch reloads.
How often have we seen Kentucky not able to get the rebound? That's going to be a foul on Daniels for the reach-in. But what they're doing is they're tapping the ball out when they know they can't catch it. Terrific job. Great save inside. Terrific hands by Daniels. The ball goes right through Hayes, then back out to Fitch, who missed two wide open jumpers. Very uncharacteristic for him.
That's right. Fitch this season shooting 46% from the three-point line, and Louisville continues to play sloppy with the basketball. Daniels in the backcourt. And here comes Azabuki.
Hawkins better come back here and take over this ball. Bad move by Kentucky.
And it's a violation called against Kentucky. 10 seconds.
Well, Hawkins was all the way up the floor that time. You can see how much they depend on him. The SEC right now has a number of undefeated teams, you can see right there, but they're not getting a lot of credit on the national scene in terms of, you know, top 10, top 25 even for that matter. But you can believe that this league, as always, come March, going to be well represented with six or seven teams in the tournament.
Mississippi State up by 20 right now against Tulane. O'Bannon around the screen, down the lane, beautifully done. And he will go to the free throw line.
Louisville, without playing anybody right in the low post area, allows for a lot of that dribble penetration on the inside. George has made his addition really count so far in the few minutes that he's played, providing some stability inside.
So here's Larry O'Bannon, a junior from Louisville, went to Mayo High School, the home of Darryl Griffith, Cardinal legend, and Mayo High School legend. Here comes a sub.
Kind of an unusual player from the floor in his career. He's averaged 36%, but he's a high range 70% free throw shooter. You don't find that very often.
Second free throw good, 12-6. Kentucky, here come more subs. Brandon Jenkins coming in for the Cardinals. So it's George, Garcia, Jenkins, O'Bannon, and Whitehead on the floor for the Cardinals.
And here's what we see. If there is an Achilles heel for Kentucky, it's the fact that they are not a deep team. And when they come in off the bench, Lukash coming in off the bench right now, there's a foul on a hold. But they come off the bench with size, and so it really changes somewhat the complexion of how the team plays. Louisville much deeper.
As you take a look at Tubby Smith, Lukash Orbzyt, a freshman from Poland, the first Polish player to ever play for Kentucky. Stockton into the front court.
Solid ball handler, keeps the ball low to the floor. Not the score, obviously, the Hawkins is, but they need to give Hawkins a blow as hard as he's been playing on both ends of the floor.
Stockton plays about 8 minutes per game, looking inside.
Double down. Good recovery by George. Zukash has got to understand when those double teams come, he's a guy that doesn't have a lot of playing experience.
Fitch dribbling it off with his foot. Shot clock winding down, hoisted at the basket. And the long rebound goes to O'Bannon.
If Kentucky had been able to recover that ball, it would have been theirs because he got it off in time and it did hit the rim.
Now Garcia quiet offensively.
He can take his man. It should be a clear out right here.
Rise and fire. And the rebound to Hayes.
Garcia should have put that ball on the floor and taken Lukash with the dribble.
Fitch penetrating the baseline, cut off. Stockton.
Sorry.
Nice move.
Oh, they called it a block.
Brandon Stockton with the step.
You'd have to question, why would you go for the charge? You know Stockton's not going to be able to get this ball over the top of George. George could have blocked that shot. It's one thing if somebody's driving like Fitch to the basket that can go over the top of you with his leaping ability, but there's no way Stockton would have been elevated over George.
Azubuike and Fitch head to the bench. Antoine Barber checks in, as well as Hawkins. So now they're going to go small in the backcourt, Billy, with Hawkins and Stockton.
Tubby Smith just trying to steal some minutes here, Gus, and use that bench, which is very short, to steal maybe 4 to 6 minutes for some of his starters. Azubuike on the bench, Daniels on the bench. Now Hawkins, Fitch on the bench. So Hawkins has got his break back out there now.
Backdoor Dean, and a whistle and foul. Lukash Orbzyt will be called for the foul.
And there's what I talked about before when Garcia took that jump shot instead of putting it on the floor. You know Lukash cannot stay with a man with quickness outside.
Under 12 to go, 15-6 Kentucky. Okay, Billy, let's see how you're doing with your singular keys of the game.
Well, so far, the Dean of the threes, I'd say Kentucky's done a very good job guarding Louisville from the outside. That 27 wins and counting, Kentucky off to a terrific start. Teacher versus pupil, maybe somewhat understated that Rick Pitino's got a 6-1 record against Tubby Smith, but Tubby can hold his own against anybody from that standpoint.
Make sure you vote now and check the results of the singular at the half. Talking about three-point shooting, Louisville to start this game 0-for-4. So the Kentucky defense playing that great perimeter defense, as you mentioned at the top of our telecast.
And that's why if you're Louisville, you have to make the adjustment quickly. Gus, and realize that they are going to go out and press with everybody on the floor and are capable of taking away the perimeter shot. So the ball's got to go down inside, either with dribble penetration or hitting somebody down low like Whitehead.
Whitehead to the basket. Beautiful soft banker.
Whitehead, five of the last six games last year, really came to the front, was the most valuable player in Conference USA postseason tournament. Picked up right where he left off now with double-doubles in most ball games.
Luke's father, Eddie, played at Louisville in the 60s. Rise of fire, Hawkins and it's wrong.
Same spot he opened the game. I think he's kind of surprising in that particular case. Surprising Louisville with that second jump shot right over Garcia, who's a terrific shot blocker and ought to be able to stop that jumper.
Hawkins with six points, and Garcia travels.
Really outstanding hedge move. You saw Kentucky use it so often yesterday in practice.
For complete play-by-play information on top 25 games, including real-time scoring and stats, click on NCAA Hoops at CBSSportsLine.com.
And with Stockton taking a lot of the ball handling responsibility off, it gives Hawkins a chance to rest a little bit, making him doubly tough on the defensive end where he can be somewhat rested. Look at that zone defense. Five guys packed in the way.
Hawkins, step back jumper. Maybe that one rebounded by Barber. Stockton all alone.
You talk about not only valuable minutes, but coming up with some valuable points.
Brandon Stockton with 6 points. And Kentucky takes a 21-8 lead. Inside, backdoor O'Bannon. And Stockton got him on the wrist.
I don't know if he did or not. That hand is part of the ball. I thought that was some block. The young man having very valuable minutes coming off of that bench. But giving up some size.
Stockton at 5'9". He may be a little smaller than 5'9", to be exact.
Guess why does everybody that's 5'9", 5'10", when you look at them now, they seem like they're probably a little smaller than them. Give the guy a break.
Let well, I'm 5'10". I think I'm 6'2", but I don't tell
anybody. He towers over the Muggsy Bogueses of this world.
And the Earl Boykins.
There you go. But he's given up a lot of size with O'Bannon, and it's tough to guard him, particularly coming off the screen down in that low post area.
21-10. Here comes Stockton, almost lost it. Saves it from going out of bounds. Now Hayes will walk it over the timeline.
Stockton has a lot of energy out there right now. Notice how it's given Hawkins plenty of rest. With Louisville stepping out like that, you're going to see some pick and rolls here shortly by Kentucky when the starters get back in. We've had a chance to watch how Louisville's defending that move.
Hawkins drives baseline, kicks it out, Stockton again! Loose ball,
did he clean house with that elbow?
Hawkins catch and shoot, and hits!
And when you're rested, you get the elevation on your jump shot. Been a brilliant move by Tubby Smith to let Hawkins not have to be the primary ball handler. It's a terrific run, and I've seen Kentucky play on numerous occasions this year. It's the best they've played.
Garcia inside, rejected, out of bounds. Barber and Hayes get a hand on it.
And do you realize the minutes that Tubby Smith is stealing right here with Fitch, Daniels, and Azubuki on the bench? Terrific interior defense.
Kentucky playing with energy and emotion. They lead 24-10.
Well, Gus, I don't think anybody's going to argue with the performance we're seeing from Kentucky right now that they belong up there at the top. Connecticut, of course, lost to Georgia Tech. You can see Georgia Tech and Duke coming on very strong right now. Arizona hanging in there. Wake Forest, a terrific win in triple overtime against North Carolina last week. Oklahoma, Calvin Sampson again has them there. Stanford, one of the strongest teams I've seen this year, particularly in depth. So this is a year in which there are so many teams capable of winning that big ball game. Today we saw Memphis beat Missouri. After that fine game, Missouri-Illinois. There's D'Artes coming off a nice screen. And that was George, as a matter of fact.
Full court pressure by Louisville, broken easily by the Wildcats. Hayes down the lane, finds Barber, as it's knocked away. Hayes with the rebound, and finally D'Artes clears it.
Right now, Garcia has got to get involved in the offense.
Taekwondo. Barber with the swooping rebound. A lot of quick jumpers for Kentucky.
They're getting good position from a rebounding standpoint. We know Hayes does that, but they're getting it from everybody today.
Orbs it.
Stockton needs to come back and get that ball. Don't let the inexperienced big man stuck out there.
Hawkins, high pick and roll. Down the lane, the runner. Way short. Aldean. Straight to the cup.
Stockton did a pretty good job there, taking away that easy layup.
And Stockton with some extended minutes.
He's actually, so far today, he's got his career high, not only in minutes, but in terms of points.
6 points.
And again, see how it keeps Hawkins away from having to handle that ball all the time.
Hawkins doing a lot of shooting in the first half. 4-12.
Smart play by Garcia. The numbers not in his favor. Kentucky got back very well on defense. But again, Garcia, I think, is being much too patient. He has got to be tougher to guard in this game to get his team back in it.
Dean changed his shot. Tapped up and in. Looks like Otis George got a hand on it.
George, D'Artez, and Garcia right now causing some problems inside.
This will be a 30-second.
And a 30-second timeout called by Kentucky.
Louisville has been up there all day long around that rim. That's the first one that softly went in. I don't know why Dean altered his shot. He had a wide open look.
24-14, Kentucky. This game has become an annual event between these two coaches. Last year, the Wildcats started off strong, but the Cardinals came on strong in the second half behind 16 points from Marvin Stone. The Cardinals won the game 81-63.
Yep, and think of some of the names that were on the floor. Ellis Miles, who is not playing this year because of the injury, but you had guys like Reese Gaines and Marvin Stone that were very instrumental in that big win for Louisville. Well, Louisville then went on a tear, Gus, if you remember, got themselves down to the number two team in the nation. Big wins over Cincinnati, played extremely good basketball, and they had that upset loss with St. Louis and really didn't finish up as well as they had that great run in January and February.
Louisville 25-7 last year, won the Conference USA tournament, but lost in the second round of the NCAAs in Birmingham to Butler. Orbs it, Azubuike, Barber, Fitch, and Daniels on the floor for Kentucky.
Zone is packed way in. Fitch needs to find himself an opening here for the jump shot.
Daniels with dribble penetration, too strong. And here comes Jenkins.
No place to go.
Inside Whitehead, great catch, rejected, but it goes down. Orbs it got there late.
Nice job by Whitehead to use his body to get Lukash away from him just enough to get that ball to inch in.
And a travel.
See a little change in momentum right here. And Kentucky starters back on the floor. Really important for Tubby Smith.
6:42 remaining in the first half. 24-16. All right, a look at the game summary. Neither team shooting a great percentage. Louisville 0 for 5 from the three-point line. And Garcia, no points thus far, Billy.
We're talking about a young man at 21 in that upset against the University of Florida. He's had two games over 20 with 24 this year. He has got to become tougher to guard the remaining part of this half. You have Louisville's a team that averages 80 points a game. Sitting there at 16 with Garcia having no points. If you're Rick Pitino, you don't want to be down, but you'd have to look up there and say, we know Garcia's going to break out, and we know we can score more points than this. Kentucky, however, has one thing going for them. They were able to rest for a long time, three of their starters, and give Hawkins a break, with Stockton doing a real nice job handling that ball. So this will be a refreshed Kentucky team going down the last 6.5 minutes.
Jenkins, Whitehead, along with Diakite, Garcia, and O'Bannon on the floor for Louisville.
Double screen for Jenkins.
Jenkins, the fade, deep on the baseline.
How about that play, setting up a double screen for a fadeaway jump shot in the corner.
Louisville on an 8-0 run. Now Hawkins, quick release. Counted.
three in a row from within about 3 feet of the same spot today.
Told you that Cliff Hawkins worked on his three-point shooting, his jump shot overall during the offseason, and you can tell he's always been good at stealing the ball.
Absolutely, and what he does is he makes his steals or blocks, whatever you want to call them, as the jump shooter is taking the ball in the air. That's the second one like that he's had today.
Daniels. Garcia taking it out of the air. That will tap. O'Bannon block. Whitehead. And Fitch comes up with the rebound.
Great defense by Hayes. A block and then an alter.
Diakite.
Well, had the ball in Diakite's hands.
In no man's land.
In no man's land. Exactly right, Gus.
At 6 feet nine.
You got to know who you're passing the ball to and at what position on the floor.
Chuck Hayes.
Garcia with the rebound again. I think that Louisville ought to set some special things for this young man. Get him started.
Garcia forcing one. Gets his own rebound.
Nice pass.
Inside Whitehead. Too strong. And a foul coming up.
You know, surprisingly, even though Kentucky is not big in size, they're doing a terrific job in the low post.
Sunday on CBS, Michael Jackson for the first time since his arrest talks to Ed Bradley. And only Ed Bradley. See this exclusive interview Sunday on 60 Minutes.
See George back into the ballgame, Dean back into the ballgame now. But I think the key for Louisville is to get Garcia off the snide here. He has not scored in his first half. He's got to be a contributor offensively.
Garcia 0 for 4.
Louisville stayed in this 2-3 zone the entire ball game.
How do you beat the zone?
Well, one of the things that Kentucky does a good job is that they surround it. They get the ball inside. They're very good passers. We haven't seen Fitch unload yet, but Hawkins has really been solid from the outside.
Baseline, Hayes, block, into the hands of Garcia. Nicely done.
That was Dean that made the block.
Now Garcia off the dribble, bump out. But Billy Cliff Hawkins has been stroking it.
He really has. The young man has just become a very solid basketball player, tremendous leader. He and Whitehead actually played at Oak Hill together where they were teammates on that club. And you can see Cliff Hawkins suffered a little bit of the academic casualty 2 years ago. Has come back strong now to show great leadership. One of the premier point guards of the country. And quite a competitor.
O'Bannon. Got it.
Nice release.
3-point basket by O'Bannon.
Larry O'Bannon.
It's down to a 6-point differential. And we talked about that change in momentum. Tubby Smith had to go to that bench knowing Louisville's much deeper. And it took away some of that continuity that Kentucky had early in this ballgame.
Kentucky has led by as many as 14 and a foul in the backcourt on Muhammad.
And Rick Pitino says to Muhammad, why did you put your hands on him? You were moving your feet very well. No need to foul from there. We can see this defense inside. There's Hawkins. The second time today, he slapped one away. Hayes, who does a terrific job at 6'6", blocking and altering shots. Kentucky has been just awesome down in the paint this year against the likes of Michigan State and Indiana last week. Just totally dominant last weekend. Hawkins back over to that spot that he likes so well.
Great anticipation by Whitehead, but he couldn't hold on. And a timeout on the floor. 3:48 to play in the first half. We've got a 6-point game.
Well, Gus, everybody a little bit younger at the time, but as we can see, these fellas have advanced to do extremely well as head coaches. We've got a national championship coach right there, Final Four coach right there, had his team number one. Herb is at NC State doing well. Ralph doing a terrific job at Holy Cross. That's some staff. Great group of teachers.
And I don't know if you can call Tubby a disciple anymore. He has done so much with so little while at Kentucky.
Well, if that's the case, we've got to call Jim Boeheim what? The ultimate leader because he started Rick out in his job. So somewhere that tree has got to start and root. Here we see that Louisville in that 2-3 zone. They've been there the whole time. Cliff Hawkins right over where he'd like to be. It's time to get Fitch open for a jump shot.
Inside Daniels, quick turn, too strong. Ripped down by Luke Whitehead.
Real energy coming out of that Kentucky offense. I really think they've got to find Fitch. Another steal by Hawkins. That's got to be at least three, maybe four on the day.
Six turnovers for Louisville. Azubuike. Louisville really starting to dig down defensively.
Well, now what we're doing, we're seeing a setup in the zone, but then they're going ahead and matching up out of it.
Azubuike on the hop, leans in a brick.
He tried to avoid the block. Probably should have put that up naturally. He would have been fouled.
Kentucky 10 of 29 from the field. Louisville 8 of 25.
This is a Kentucky team that's been averaging close to 60% from the floor, so you can see how well Louisville's been playing defense in this first half.
Here's Fitch. That one off the glass, and another rebound.
Considering the score and time, not a good pass to throw.
Six turnovers for Kentucky.
Garcia coming back into the game for the last 2 minutes. Good job by Fitch getting out there. They're not giving Wade any wide open looks.
So Dean pulls it out. They spread the floor. Approaching the 2 minute mark of the first half. O'Bannon hard down the lane. Great deal.
Oh,
George misses the checker.
Nobody in the way either. Terrific feed by O'Bannon. George should have put that one away.
Hawkins.
Nice hands.
Fitch. And a foul up top.
Dean gets there too late. Fitch goes right by, playing him for the jump shot.
Now coming up on Singular at the half, Jim Nance and Bill Raftery. We'll have scores and highlights from today's action, plus the results of the Singular fan in the stands, keys to the game poll. That's all coming up on Singular at the half. And your buddy Jim Nance double dipping today. Football in the morning and basketball in the afternoon.
Very capable. There may be a golf tournament coming up somewhere in here. Go for a trimester. I'm anxious to see if Rick Pitino sets up some kind of an offensive play for Garcia in one of the last possessions they'll get of the half.
Inside, Daniels turns. Halfway down, pops out, moves, who wants it? Knocked out of bounds with a foul coming up.
They all want it, who can get it? It's exactly. Amazing the space that Hayes takes when he goes up with those two-handed rebounds. Much like probably the greatest player ever to play for Louisville. Way back in the days, Wes Unsell had a body bigger than Hayes's, but he was probably the master at going up with two hands, using that body, and then with his great two-handed outlet pass, setting it up better than maybe anybody that's played the college game with that play.
Muhammad tips it ahead to the basket. Up
Oh!
Muhammad speaks.
A little payback. His brother, of course, played for the University of Kentucky under Rick Pitino. Terrific defensive play and hustle here. And he's going up against Hawkins and still gets not only the basket, but goes to the line.
Alhaji Muhammad earned a scholarship for this year after playing in 18 games last season. So Muhammad steps to the line, trying to make this a three-point game.
Had 11 points this year, 3 rebounds, 3 steals against Western Kentucky, so certainly capable.
And he gets the bounce.
There you go, picking up full court right here. It is interesting how the momentum of this game changed when Tubby Smith, and he got productive minutes off the bench, but had to go to that bench. The intensity level early by the starters was incredible. Took Louisville right out of their game.
They stopped it. Great dribbling to bring it up the floor. Louisville has it stripped by Muhammad again. Muhammad to the bucket.
Two incredible plays by Muhammad. We're talking about 5 points off steals on his part.
And stopped it out of control.
Ooh, a big foul. You don't want to commit the foul. The clock was in their favor. Here we're going to see Muhammad. Terrific job on his part, and then off to the races. Excellent composure here, realizing Stockton's on his back, just as he did with Hawkins before. Lays it up beautifully.
For the Cats checking in the lineup.
Louisville is on a 16-3 run, Billy. Kentucky won for their last 15 from the field.
That was not a wise foul. Put Stockton on the line. Kentucky's having a trouble scoring in the half-court set. Get back and play solid defense if you're Louisville.
Stockton, a 75% free throw shooter. And he gets the front end.
the momentum changer here right before the half. Louisville should have tried to play solid defense.
Remember, Kentucky led by as many as 14 here in the first half. Second one, good to Stockton.
Well, last year, Louisville was down by 11 in the first half and came back to win that ball game. So these teams know how to play.
Oh, and Whitehead took his eyes off the ball.
Well, Muhammad probably should have given Whitehead a chance to go back door. And he tried to make his move and just wasn't able to get back in time. Big turnover. So there you have a foul turnover. Poorly calculated play by Louisville, and then just a careless pass.
Seven Louisville turnovers in the first half. Cardinals very aggressive as they sit back in the zone as Stockton pulls it out, tries the other side. Stockton for three. Short. Oh, the rim.
Just nicked the rim, and that's why Whitehead didn't make the catch. Big break for Kentucky. You don't want to foul here.
Knocked away into the hands of Whitehead. Shot clock turned off. Game clock at 15.
Good solid defense by Kentucky. Can Whitehead take Hayes? Hayes has been pretty good handling off the dribble.
Stop and start to the bucket. No. Rebounded by the Cats. Here's Azabuki from midcourt. And that'll do it.
Nice defense by Hayes on Whitehead. Moved his feet. Didn't try to foul with his hands.
But Louisville goes on a 16-7 run to end the first half, 31-26, Kentucky. Now let's go to New York and Jim Nance.
All right, Gus, good first half there. Thank you very much. Coming up, singular at the half, all the scores and highlights from college basketball as we continue on CBS after this message. And a word from your local station.
Welcome back to Lexington, 31-26. Kentucky with the lead over Louisville. Gus Johnson along with Billy Packer. The irony in this whole situation is the two top scorers are a combined 0-for-8, Garcia and Fitch.
I think it's really important for Garcia to get off in a good stead here in the second half. When you really take a look at stats, some of the things that jump out at me is that the stardom of Whitehead, Garcia, and Dean are 6-for-17 in that first half. 2-for-17. And then when you turn around and you take a look at what the bench did for Louisville, they were 7-for-10. So very productive. And here you see Muhammad, who did a terrific job with those steals coming in there, as did Stockton do a terrific job for Kentucky. Cliff Hawkins hitting those jumpers early really got Kentucky off to a good start. But these are some crazy stats out here. As you mentioned, Fitch is 0-for-4. He was 1-for-11 in that UCLA game earlier this year. But very uncharacteristic. The guy that's been, with the exception of the UCLA game, extremely solid.
Gerald Fitch coming off a 26-point game against Eastern Kentucky. He's from Macon, Georgia. Played the point last year, now at the two.
So, Gus, I'm going to take a shot here. It's going to be which guy plays better in the second half. Fitch or Garcia is going to determine the winner of this game.
I agree with you.
One of those two have got to start being productive.
Both of the players very patient and unselfish.
That they are, but there are times when you have to become harder to guard than they have been in the first half. What a fake by Hawkins.
Hawkins finds Azabuki.
Azabuki has a terrific release on his jump shot. Got it up in perfect position to shoot right on the catch.
In the first half, Louisville trailed by as many as 14, but managed to cut it to one at 27-26 before Kentucky scored the last 4 points of the first half. Garcia, the hard banker.
That was probably the toughest shot that he had to put up all day. Being guarded by Daniels and still got it over the top of him.
Francisco finally getting on the board. His first field goal of the game. Loose ball knocked away.
Good job by Garcia that time filling the lane. Good bounce pass.
Whitehead spinning. Misses. Out of bounds. Will stay right here.
Excellent no call by the official there. We'll see Garcia going in and over Daniels, who's 6'8", but's got the long arms. That was a tough shot.
Mike Juan Dean.
Hawkins has given Dean all he can handle on the outside. Dean hadn't been able to get anything off. He's 0 for 5 from the field.
No points for Dean. Garcia fires from downtown.
Not a good shot.
Loose ball knocked out of bounds. We'll head the other way. Sunday on CBS, Michael Jackson for the first time since his arrest talks to Ed Bradley and only Ed Bradley. See this exclusive interview Sunday on 60 Minutes.
You know, guys, another thing interesting in this game, Kentucky in the first half had 6 blocks. Louisville only 2. Louisville number 2 in the nation with 8 blocks a game. There's an offensive foul. Hawkins swinging. Hits Dean. Official wisely calls it. No need for that foul. Here we're going to see the elbow thrown right there. No question. The call's going to be made right in front of the official. Foolish foul, about the only thing Hawkins has done wrong all day.
And that's usually what Hawkins forces opponents to do. Ooh, he frustrates them so much defensively.
And look at what that did to Tubby. He got up snarling, and he's going to take Hawkins out of the ballgame to back in with Stockton to calm him down a little.
And an offensive foul called on Louisville.
There's D'Artes on the handoff. Trying to rub off the screen.
D'Artes picks up his first. Hawkins has 3 fouls.
Let's look at Hawkins as he walks by Tubby Smith to see whether there's a little statement. No, he just sends him right to the bench and gives him the lip. Hawkins will sit.
Now Stockton has done a terrific job off the bench.
At his career high here in the first half of this ball game.
In the corner, Fitch rides and fire.
That ball was not intended for Fitch on the pass, but a good job by Hayes to let it go.
36-28 Kentucky.
How long does Tubby Smith let Hawkins sit and stew over there, Cass?
Dean lost it in the corner. Garcia.
Nice decision.
Now Dean wide open. Off the heel of the rim and out of bounds.
Now Dean, who set a Louisville record hitting 9 threes against VMI, has got to go up stronger on his jump shot than that and stay with it. You don't set a record as he did, being a prolific outside shooter, and have the technique he showed on that shot. Very lazy jump shot.
Hawkins frustrated on the bench after picking up his 3rd foul. Dean is 0 for 6. From the field, 0 for 3 from the 3-point line.
Yeah, Tubby Smith is a tremendous leader as a coach, and I don't care how well Hawkins been playing. He got disciplined on that move, and he's on that bench, and he'll sit there a while.
Daniels missing at point-blank range. Here comes Dean in transition.
Stop by Stockton.
I like Stockton today, yeah.
He is having a fine game.
Now Dean down the lane. Hangs in the air!
Second shot in this half over Daniels' outstretched arms. The first one by Garcia.
First basket of the game for Tyquan Dean. 6-point lead for Kentucky.
Hayes wants him inside. Nobody getting any direct passes to him.
Here's Daniels. Double the double. Somebody's open. It's Fitch. But Garcia closes. Fitch forces one up.
Excellent recovery that time by Garcia on Fitch. We're not seeing the skip passes that Kentucky normally throws when they go cross court. And it's one extra pass, and that's why Louisville's able to recover so quickly.
D'Artes in the high post.
Crowd's been somewhat taken out of the game here. Nice help.
Fitch steals it away. Here comes Fitch, the senior. And a foul on the sideline.
Here we see Dean driving, and that's, as I said, the second time in this half, a beautiful half hook by Dean to get that shot over Daniels. He's listed at 6'8", plays bigger than that. You can see those long arms of his, but he can't get to the ball.
And that's what you like to see from a shooter. If the ball isn't going in from the perimeter, take it to the basket.
Absolutely. That dribble penetration will set up some of that outside jump shooting.
6-point lead for Kentucky.
Jenkins into the game. He played well in the first half.
Azabuki rips one on the baseline.
Boy, he's got a good-looking stroke.
10 points for Azabuki, and the fans are back into it. here at Rupp. 9-point lead for the Cats.
Again, we still don't see Garcia effectively getting the ball in offensive scoring position, and it's hurting his ball field.
15:34 to go in the second half. Kentucky up by 9. Let's take a look back at the 96 National Championship. And it was the last time the Final Four was played in a non-dome arena. Rick Pitino and the Kentucky Wildcats faced Jim Boeheim and his Syracuse Orangemen. The Wildcats, behind 7 three-pointers from Tony Delk, won their 6th national championship and the first for Rick Pitino.
You know, Gus, that particular year in December, Kentucky beat Louisville 89-66. That same Tony Delk had 30, which is the most points scored in this particular rivalry. Kentucky going on to win the national championship, as just seen. Then in 98, in Tubby's first year, Louisville came in here probably with no chance whatsoever to win. They pulled off a 79-76 upset, I think the biggest upset in the series. Kentucky then went on to win the national championship under Tubby Smith.
Inside, O'Bannon, the jump hook, rims around and out. Kentucky leads the series 23-11. They've won 3 of the last 4 as O'Bannon. You know, steps to the line. Daniels picks up his 2nd.
You kind of get the feeling Louisville is getting back into this game. Then you look up at the scoreboard and Kentucky is opening up a margin. Now you have Tubby Smith over there talking to Hawkins. They're going back and forth, which means to me that very shortly we're going to see Hawkins back into the game. Tubby Smith probably made his point with his outstanding point guard to say, look, we don't need that elbow swinging. Let's get back into this ball game.
Second free throw good. Although Hawkins is on the bench, they've gotten a fine performance from Brandon Stockton, who only averages 7 minutes per game, at 7 minutes in the first half, as he breaks the pressure and gets it into the front court.
To me, he has actually been the player of the game so far.
Certainly has.
Not only in regard to his productivity, but the fact that he's played these valuable minutes so well.
Fitch turns it over on the sideline.
And Tubby, very confident with Stockton right now. He's leaving him out there.
He's a perfect example of if you learn how to play the game fundamentally, and if you can do all the little things without the flash, some coach is going to give you a chance to get out there on the floor.
George setting some big screens out there. Fitch got caught.
Jenkins down the lane. Nice catch, Whitehead. Can't finish. Gets the tap and it rolls home.
Again, though, Hayes altered that shot. Whitehead with a terrific second leap.
Stockton chases it down.
Kentucky not in the normal flow right now with Hawkins out of the ballgame, however.
Wide open. Fitch in the corner. Pulls the trigger. Rims out. Hayes with the rebound. Power dribble. Has it blocked. Gets it back. Tied.
How about Jenkins on the floor for the tie-up?
And the possession arrow favors Louisville.
Great hustle. Here we see that tip. Whitehead. Now watch the second leap, because Hayes does a great job altering this shot. Whitehead gets himself right back up in the air. The soft touch and the roll.
Luke Whitehead. Quick jumper.
You watch, the second jump is the key here. People standing and watching. He bounced on the floor and right back up again.
So here comes Brandon Jenkins, a freshman from Detroit, along with Garcia, backdoor, stolen away. Azubuike.
Azubuike with good defense against that backdoor cut. No passing lane available.
Now Fitch.
He sets a screen, doesn't he? He wants it inside, not getting the ball when he's open.
Fitch driving baseline. 14 to shoot. Hayes deals it down. Daniel rejected. Garcia got it.
Garcia led his team in shot blocks last year with 40.
Garcia down the lane. Beautiful finger roll.
People wanted a walk on that move from the outside, but you can see what this young guy can do as a finisher.
Remember, he's 6'7".
Plays about 6'9".
6-0 run for Louisville. 3-point lead for the Cats.
I think it's time for Hawkins back in this ball game.
He's got three fouls. Fitch, Garcia all over him. No room for Gerald Fitch to square. Azubuike pulls it. And it comes down to George. Hawkins waiting to get back into this game. George for three.
Oh my goodness. Boy, you got to question that shot, Gus. Making a nice comeback. George takes an outside shot. Not what you want if you're Louisville.
With the conclusion of today's game, we will select the Chevrolet most valuable player of the game for each team. Chevrolet will make a contribution to each school's general scholarship fund, a tradition for over 30 years. And here comes Cliff Hawkins back into the game. Gerald Fitch takes the seat, and Stockton remains on the floor. Barber also on the floor.
I talked about that foul right before the half when Louisville had momentum. There you have not a foul, but you have a mental mistake, George. He's 0 for 4 in the year on three, taking the three when it's not necessary, giving Kentucky an easy opportunity to get the ball back.
Hawkins off the heel of the rim, tapped around. Muhammad with the rebound. And here come the Cardinals, down by three.
D'Artez not open, but Dean makes a wise move, not throwing that unnecessary pass.
Louisville playing with more energy right now and confidence. D'Artez wins it right out of bounds.
Azubuike today has shown a very good stroke from the outside and solid defense because he's been matched up with Garcia a lot today. So solid. Look at that squaring up with that jump shot, bearing it home.
10 points for Azubuike. Here's Hawkins along with Stockton. Barber around the screen, and Muhammad pulled a little bit of his jersey.
Azubuike sitting on that bench right now with Daniels and Fitch. So Tubby Smith realizing he's got a long way to go in this game, going up against a team with a deeper bench. You talk about this Conference USA this year. We showed the SEC with the strength that it has with unbeaten teams, but you know, Memphis today beating, as I mentioned, Missouri. You've got Cincinnati undefeated, playing extremely well under Bobby Huggins. Charlotte has a nice team. Marquette with a club that made it the Final Four last year. DePaul with a win today over Seton Hall. A solid lead. And the zone matching up a little bit more. It shows a 2-3. Hayes has got that range.
Chuck Hayes. With 4 points now.
Hasn't been able to get the ball in the low post, so he just steps out a little bit. Asks the fans to get into this game. Louisville gets close, but they can't get over.
Back door, Muhammad. And he rips it down.
Wow, Barber lost it completely on that play. We talk about Stockton have a good game off the bench. Muhammad is as well, Gus.
Couple of steals. Barber. Lost his footing, gets it back, and does not make the wise pass.
Exactly. You've got to think who you're throwing it to. A big man really not going to catch it in traffic. It's amazing how the mental mistakes start to pile up.
D'Artez is limping a little bit. Here's Dean, crosses over, down the lane, and a travel. And Rick Pitino can't believe it. 41-38 the score, 10:44 to play in the second half. CBS Sports coverage of the NCAA men's basketball will continue after this.
Well, Gus, we see this year so many teams capable of winning. The ACC with five teams in the top 25. We're going to see one of them, the University of North Carolina, coming into Kentucky next week. The Big 12 with four. Surprisingly out here, the Pac-10 with just two, Arizona and Stanford. Stanford, as I pointed out, an outstanding team. I think the SEC will jump more into the pile as their teams start to go head-to-head against each other. But you can see balance throughout the entire country. A lot of teams capable of winning that next big game.
41-38, Kentucky with the lead over Louisville. Kentucky, the number one team in the nation against the 20th-ranked Louisville Cardinals. Fitch. Lazy pass, almost knocked away.
Whitehead could have had that if he would have been prepared and would have been off to the races.
Here's Barber down the lane, kicks it out. Hawkins, one dribble, fires. Flat and short.
Somewhat, I thought, nipped that time by Muhammad.
Louisville can get even closer right here. Whitehead drives a baseline. Stripped out of bounds right off of his foot. Terrific job by Hayes.
His footwork defensively kind of staggers your imagination for a guy that's built that powerfully to be able to move that quickly and square up on the defensive end. He's a player that gets a lot of respect and attention nationally, but he is really underrated even on that basis. A winner.
Here comes Hawkins, guarded by Tyquan. Great crossover. Looks inside, stolen away by Whitehead. What a beautiful job by Whitehead. In the corner, Dean. Rebound, step back in by George.
We saw D'Artez with that slight leg injury, and George was put into the game. Did he sky on that play?
Otis George.
And with a chance to tie this up.
By George, who will be at the line for one.
Now, this is what I mentioned before. George took that three-point shot before. It took away some momentum. Here we see him come out of nowhere to put that ball back up. Now with this free throw, has a chance to tie things up here for Louisville.
George is from the Commonwealth of Dominican, which is in the Caribbean between Trinidad and Tobago. He was on their junior national volleyball team, so no surprise that he can get up.
And a tie ball game.
Five rebounds for George, 9 points. Daniels picks up his third.
And remember, Hawkins has 3 fouls.
And Hawkins throws it away. Garcia. Down the lane, George again. And Louisville takes the lead.
Timeout, Kentucky. Yep, they've got to take a timeout here. A terrific comeback by Louisville. Doing it on the defensive end and then transition baskets.
13-2 run for the Cardinals, who take a 43-41 lead.
CBS Sports College Basketball coverage is sponsored by Capital One. What's in your wallet? Icy Hot Patch. It's icy first to dull the pain, then hot to relax pain away for hours. And by Budweiser. Grab a cold, fresh Budweiser. It's game time.
Earlier in this ballgame, we talked about Louisville with bad defensive balance. Now, here's a case where we're going to see the opposite take place. Kentucky, with Hawkins trying to make a penetration move on the inside, leaves nobody back here, enables Louisville not only to make the steal when Hawkins has no place to go, but look at the lack of balance. There's a 4-on-1, basically, and a great job by Garcia to hand off at the last second and sidestep the potential charge.
And the Louisville bench outscoring the Kentucky bench, 28-10, O'Bannon, George, and Muhammad all coming off the bench and playing well. Muhammad with 7, O'Bannon with 9, and George with 10.
Kentucky with 9 minutes to go, however, back to their regular starting lineup. And you got to figure that they'll be in a position to go the rest of the way after running any fouls. Hawkins trying to get the lob, nothing there.
Louisville trail by as many as 14 in the first half. And now lead by 2.
Really working on their set half-court offense right here. A lot of team movement, but good defense so far.
Daniels looks weak side to Hawkins, inside Hayes.
No help.
Drop step, pumps, forced up a bad shot again.
Boy, great defense. There was no help initially. Then George came over and with those long arms did the job. George has really helped off the bench as have a number of Louisville players, particularly in the defensive end.
And look at the Kentucky shooting in the second half, 30%. Louisville has kicked it up to 54. Garcia.
How about that follow through? As I said, the player, Fitcher Garcia, that has the bigger second half can lead his team to victory. And so far, it's been Garcia, particularly on the defensive end of the floor.
Garcia, no points in the first half, has 7 total now, all coming in the second half.
Dean doing a nice job staying with Hawkins away from the ball.
And a reach and foul coming up on Tyquan Dean. Now don't forget, next Saturday it's a full day of college basketball excitement on CBS. North Carolina comes here to Lexington to take on top-ranked Kentucky, while Michigan State takes on the defending national champion, Syracuse Orangemen.
That baton deathmatch march schedule of Tom Izzo continues going to the Dome, and we will have next week on this floor the number 1 and number 2 teams in the country in terms of wins in NCAA history.
Daniels, and he tips in his own miss.
Just as we saw Whitehead on the other end, there's Daniel with a good second leap.
That breaks a 10-0 Louisville run. Now the fans rise to their feet at a Rupp Arena.
Really don't know if this is wise to have Jenkins trying to challenge Hawkins with the dribble.
7:47 remaining in the second half. 3-point lead for the Cardinals. Welcome back. The game summary. The Louisville bench outscoring the Kentucky bench 29-10. Gus Johnson along with Billy Packer. Billy, this reminds me of the game last year.
It was. Louisville down in the first half, came back with solid performance in the second to take the lead and then eventually win the game. Second half shooting by Kentucky, 5-for-15. Not as bad back in 1999 when Kentucky won over Louisville. Louisville in the second half missed 21 of their first 22 shots in the second half to lose that ball game. So Kentucky not quite as bad, but really out of sync here offensively. Give a lot of credit to Louisville's defense, particularly Garcia on the inside. This is a bad move. Jenkins out here with Hawkins.
And a push foul.
Oh, that's his fourth. Hawkins was doing the job on Jenkins. That picks up his fourth. He's probably going to have to sit with 7:40 to go.
All right, let's take a look at the CBS Sports Line stat of the game. Field goal percentage in the second half. Louisville shooting 54%. Kentucky 33%. For complete game stats, go to cbs.sportsline.com.
This gives Dean an opportunity to have a little bit more of a rest. And Hawkins with four fouls. Boy, this is a big loss for Kentucky going down a stretch.
Here's Garcia, has it stripped. Azubuike tripped and fouled by Garcia.
Nice steal by Azubuike.
Garcia, that's his third team fifth.
Sunday on CBS, Michael Jackson for the first time since his arrest talks to Ed Bradley and only Ed Bradley. See exclusive interview. The exclusive interview Sunday on 60 Minutes. Third foul called on Garcia.
Reggie Theus now at a Louisville assistant giving Jenkins some lessons in regard to how to dribble against a good defender. Here we have Dean back into the ball game, so they'll give Reggie a chance maybe to give a few more words to him. Nice double down.
Inside Hayes, great catch, wraps it around. Somehow Daniels angles it in.
Those two guys, an interior passing and catching, as good as there is in college basketball.
Kentucky within one.
A lot of ebb and flow in this game in regard to teams getting out of sync, as Louisville does there.
Here's Fitch, he's got Daniels with him. Fitch to the bucket, up and in. No charge.
And a great no call by the official.
And Kentucky reclaims the lead. Rick Pitino wants a timeout. The Wildcats on a 6-0 run. Fitch, the senior, taking it strong to the goal. All right, the game reset. Kentucky with three timeouts left. Louisville with only one. The possession arrow in the favor of the Cats.
You know, guess what's been interesting in this game? It seems like every time momentum swings, it swings on the defensive end of the floor or by a bad offensive decision. Not necessarily play, but decision by one or the other team. Right now we see Kentucky coming back to take the lead with terrific play on the defensive end, and that's what this game has been all about.
And to add to your point, Louisville has turned it over 15 times, resulting in 20 Kentucky points off turnovers. Kentucky has turned it over 14 times, resulting in 16 Louisville points off.
Exactly. So that has been the story of this ball game. Can somebody stay in their offensive set to get a decent shot off?
Garcia.
That's a bookie staying right with him, isn't he?
Whitehead, turnaround jumper on the baseline, rims out.
Nice defense by Hayes. A decent shot to take.
And the question will be, can Brandon Stockton handle the pressure over the last 6 minutes of this game running the Kentucky offense? Or at least until Hawkins can come back in. Fitch and a bump.
Well, Whitehead had to come out to protect against the jumper by Fitch, who has not really been in offensive stride today. And when he did that, Fitch wisely just went right on by him.
Rick Pitino shouting out plays.
Oh, Garcia gonna come out of the ball game right now.
What a game for this young man.
Stockton has been the answer for Kentucky. Hayes.
Daniels up and in from Hayes.
What was going on with weak side help? Daniels snuck right in behind the entire Louisville weak side defense.
Kentucky on an 8-0 run. Daniels with 8 points. O'Bannon now down the lane, hangs in the air, off the side of the rim. Daniels with the rebound.
Great block out by Daniels, put himself in position.
Here comes Fitch. Dribble penetration. Now Dean the other way. Both teams running end to end. And a reaching foul coming up on Daniels.
Here we see, we talked about the interior passing, Daniels and Hayes. Here's where Hayes steps out, and look at Daniels, who is a very potent scorer, sneaking in behind the weak side defense of Louisville. Nobody falling back. Big mistake.
And Daniels, though, just picked up his fourth foul.
So you've got Hawkins with four, Daniels with four.
Whitehead,
5 minutes to go.
And he buries it.
Basket by Whitehead.
Luke Whitehead makes it a 49-48 game. Stockton in the backcourt.
Houdini don't want to follow him.
Down the lane, Stockton, bad shot.
Yes, sir, not the shot that if you're Kentucky you want. Stockton's job is to get the ball over half court and set up. That's going to bring Hawkins right back into the ballgame.
Garcia.
Whitehead showing some respect for Hayes.
All alone, Dartez.
And there's where the double down hurts you. Good movement by D'Artez. It's good to see him back in the game. Looked like he had that leg injury. Might keep him out a while.
Stockton. But as you see, Stockton turns it over, and Louisville scores a point off the turnover.
A mental mistake again.
50-49, Louisville. Azubuki. Fouled on the release, and that's
four, isn't it?
Should be three shots for Azubuki.
And that's the fourth foul on Garcia. You see the good movement without the ball. Kentucky happy to double down on the inside, but Whitehead gets it to D'Artez, who puts it away without any trouble. Nobody even guarding him.
Garcia, as you mentioned, Billy picked up his fourth. So Kalena Azubuki at the free throw line, an 83% free throw shooter, shooting three.
He was 5-for-7, 11 points against Indiana last week. The only game, down game that he's had this year, he didn't score against Michigan State.
This is the second. One more coming. Luke Whitehead checks out of the game momentarily, and Otis George comes back in.
That's only the third miss on the year for Azubuki. Excellent stroke on his shot.
Sophomore from Tulsa, Oklahoma, averaged 39 points a game as a high school player. Second, third one up, rather, is good. And Kentucky takes a one-point lead.
Now, if you're Garcia, one of the things you have to be very careful of is if you're going to drive to that basket, not charge it.
Taekwon Dean cut off inside. D'Artez up and in.
D'Artez doing a terrific job away from the ball, cutting to the basket, making himself available. Two putbacks in a row. D'Artez and Dean down inside.
Here's Hawkins. They spread it out for him. Pulls up. Off the back of the rim.
Another good bench performance here. Muhammad, who's had a good game. Loose balls, two steals in that first half. That was a pretty good shot for Hawkins to take there.
Good look. Backdoor cut by Muhammad. Covered nicely. Dean from the parking lot.
Oh!
3-point basket by
Taekwon Dean.
And he faded away on that shot in addition to being probably, what would you say, 28 to 30 feet away.
No question about it. And Louisville takes a 55-51 lead.
A little pick and roll coming up with Hayes and Hawkins. Ooh. Garcia almost reached in for his fifth foul.
Here's Hayes. Guarded by D'Artez. Across the lane, off the glass, no. Loose ball snatched out of the air by Dean. first seven games of the season, Kentucky has trailed for only a minute and 7 seconds. Today, they've trailed for over 4 minutes. Knocked away as a Azabuki with the ball. Turnaround jumper, no.
Probably shouldn't have taken a shot. The numbers favored Louisville, 3-2. Bring the ball back out. You're down 4 points. You don't need a shot that can't be rebounded.
Louisville has already knocked off one number one this season when they defeated Florida. Can they make it their second number one? D off the heel. George with the rebound.
Will they bring it back out? They've got clock in their favor.
Now Muhammad.
They're not thinking right now. Bring the ball back out. Get reset. Get a decent look.
Taekwon D. Fadeaway jumper. 11-footer. Rims around and out. Great rebound, George, and a foul as the Louisville bench explodes. That's a minute and 42 away.
Is fatigue setting in a little bit for that front line of Kentucky? Both Daniels and Hayes extremely tired and had to play all the way down the stretch. We'll see Dean from way downtown bury that three. Look at how far out he is. He's almost sitting on the U in UK out in the center of the court.
But what a game for Otis George, the junior. 11 points, 8 rebounds. And he gets his 12th point of the game as Whitehead checks back in.
Only game bigger statistically for him. 16 points, 10 rebounds against Eastern Kentucky. Not quite the same style of opponent. Cortez sits down, did a good job. Ian George really caused problems. Up on the glass and a missed shot.
And Louisville has its largest lead of the game with 1:42 to play in the second half. Kentucky has won 27 consecutive regular season games. Their last loss at Louisville almost a year to the day.
364 days ago. Terrific comeback. And Kentucky's had 14 straight in that stretch that they've won here in Rupp Arena. Nothing to match the great unbeaten streak that Adolph Rupp had at Kentucky, the all-timer. But a nice run in this day of modern college basketball. Louisville doesn't pick up full court. So Hawkins lets the ball come in without picking it up, so no time goes off the clock.
57-51 Louisville. Fitch takes a three.
Got it. He got
the foul.
He was fouled.
Holy Toledo. And just like that, Kentucky's right back in it.
What is Dean thinking? First of all, you prevent the ball getting to Fitch, even though he hasn't done it today. But you've got to go up square on the shot. You're not going to block that shot. Big mistake by Louisville.
Fitch has the free throw. 1:35 to go, 57-55 Louisville.
And Louisville, who did not press Kentucky, finds Kentucky pressing them, the crowd right back into the game. Barber with fresh legs on Dean.
Remember, Barber taller, longer. Here's Whitehead.
Oh, scary with George with the hands on the ball. Azabuki's done a nice job on Garcia.
Garcia fires a three.
Oh, that's it. Goodness. Great defense. He just put it right over him.
107 to play.
So we had the two guys that we said were stars. One coming through.
And a timeout call by Kentucky. Francisco Garcia with a huge three. All 10 of his points coming in the second half. Tonight on a special CBS movie presentation, Will Smith, Kevin Kline, and Selma Hayek star in the blockbuster hit, The Wild Wild West, followed by Saturday's number one drama, The District, tonight on CBS. Big-time players come up with big-time plays.
Absolutely. Garcia's jump shot over Azabuki, who has been doing a terrific job on him throughout this game. That was just a big-time three-point shot, as was Fitch's.
Louisville up by five. Kentucky with the ball.
Don't have to think three here.
Still plenty of time to go for two. Good step out by Whitehead.
Fitz takes the three. Daniels with the rebound. Off the glass. No, and he's fouled.
Well, Fitz kind of clutched that one and tried to pick up the foul. Nice job on his part just to get it up to the rim. There you see the shot. Good rotation on it. Daniels with two hands goes back in, alters the shot. There he goes with his patented left-handed move.
Very good in around the basket because he can use his natural left hand and also with the right hand.
So Billy with 47.5 to go. If Daniels hits these two free throws, gets the first one, Kentucky falls back and plays for a stop.
Oh, absolutely. Absolutely. They have plenty of time here left on the clock.
O'Bannon comes back in. Muhammad, who's had a terrific game, heads to the bench. Daniels, one more on the way. A 66% free throw shooter. Long, that one long.
Haynes with the rebound. Left hand over the top, kept it alive. That's an illegal screen. Kentucky gets by with it.
Fitz down the lane. Batted out in the corner as a bouquet. And a foul coming up against Barber.
That's going to be Barber over the back. Terrific job, though, by Kentucky to keep that ball alive on three occasions. Barber came over the back on the play.
Azubuike got a great look at the basket. And he just couldn't knock it down.
He stayed right with the shot, just wouldn't go. And there you see Barber crashing over the top of Whitehead, trying to get that rebound. Is it going to be George or Whitehead? It looks like Whitehead's going to the other line. Who's going to this line?
O'Bannon. It's O'Bannon.
Could have been called either way.
O'Bannon, a 72% free throw shooter on the season. And he gets the first.
Right now, Kentucky has got to think three. Because they really need the possessions the rest of the way.
Bannon perfect from the line today. 7 of 7. Make it 8 of 8.
Yep. Got to be thinking three quick. If you're Hawkins, get the ball up there. Fitch, ready to go.
One dribble, fires a three. Around the rim and out. Whitehead clears it. And how about this? For the second time this season, Rick Pitino and the Louisville Cardinals will knock off a number one.
Well, what's interesting is Louisville went all the way back before they beat a number one team to 1953. They beat Seton Hall with Walter Dukes, and I think Richie Reagan was still on that basketball team. They beat them 73-67. They had not beaten the number one team since that, 1953. Now they come up, beat number one Florida, and now number one Kentucky.
Today's game produced by Bob Dekus. Directed by Craig Silver.
Not a bad day for Conference USA. DePaul beating Seton Hall, as we mentioned. Memphis beating Missouri. And here, Louisville knocking off Kentucky.
Whitehead misses the second, knocked out of bounds. We'll head the other way with 22.8 to go.
And Rick Pitino goes to 18-1 against former pupils, either players or coaches that assisted for him.
Hawkins in the front court. Out of bounds with 15.9 to go.
Well, here we have the situation in regard to people that have knocked off number ones. Louisville had beaten Florida. Now they beat Kentucky, as I mentioned. So that number one is really a misnomer in college basketball as we know it, or as we used to know it.
5 seconds. Can't get it in. Stolen out of the air by Whitehead. And that should do it.
And I think Fitch hurt himself on that move. It's a terrific win for Louisville and sets the stage for a big game coming up next week right here on this floor with the University of North Carolina coming in.
Whitehead. So Whitehead heads to the line, 15 seconds to go. What a tremendous win for this Louisville Cardinals team. Coming into Lexington, snapping Kentucky's 14-game home winning streak and 27-game unbeaten streak, which dates back to last season.
Well, I remember talking to Reggie Theus before this game. He said he remembers coming in here after his 1977 team went to the Final Four. They came in here and played what eventually became the national champion Kentucky team in 78. And he said they gave us a pretty good beating. So for his second trip, it's been a little bit more pleasurable. Young guy that's certain to be
a head coach somewhere down the line.
Big win for Louisville.
The Louisville Cardinals do it again. 65-56 over Kentucky, and number one falls. The Chevrolet most valuable players of the game are Otis George and Cliff Hawkins. Chevrolet will make a contribution to each school's general scholarship fund to reward outstanding students for their academic achievements and to assist those in financial need. And don't forget tonight on a special CBS movie presentation, Will Smith, Kevin Kline, Selma Hayek in the Wild, Wild West. That's followed by Saturday's number one drama, The District, tonight on CBS. So for Billy Packer, this is Gus Johnson saying so long from Lexington. 65-56, Louisville knocks off number one. This has been a presentation of CBS Sports, home of the men's NCAA basketball championship.
Basketball is to Kentucky what bluegrass is to music. Something timeless, something that defines us, a piece of Kentucky history. Today's game will now become part of that history. It was 90 years ago that Louisville and UK faced each other for the first time. UK won, but it would not always be the case. The Cards beat the Cats 4 out of the next 11 games before the series was interrupted in 1959.
Turpin lean in. It is going to be a charge.
In 1983, the two teams played what fans dubbed the Dream Game. Louisville returned with the victory. But it's UK that's racked up the most wins in the matchup. Ironically, it's the history on the gridiron that's often defined this game. If the past holds true, when UK and Louisville meet on the football field, the winner will lose when they meet again on the court. This year, Louisville took the win home, leaving UK defeated 40-24.
Cartez to the basket.
Now, when the Cardinals and Wildcats take the court against each other, each player gets a history lesson in the pride, the heart, and the will that defines the battle of the Bluegrass.
Eyes of fire.
Let's go to the videotape and pick it up in the first frame when it was all UK from the opening bell. Cliff Hawkins showing extremely good Kentucky defense with a steal to Eric Daniels for the basket. 10-2 Kentucky in front. It was more Kentucky defense. Block after block after block. This time eventually to Kalina Azubuike. Suddenly the Wildcats flew in front 12-2. One of the bright shining stars of the first half for Kentucky was Brandon Stockton, in for Cliff Hawkins with a three. 21-8 Kentucky in front. But Hawkins played extremely well in the first half. He seemed motivated, inspired. 4 3-pointers, the last of them put UK in front 27-18. Then it looked like the Wildcats began to tire. U of L took the punch and came back on a 16-3 run. Larry O'Bannon with a three, 27-21 UK. And Al-Haji Muhammad began showing Cardinals steel. With the steal and the score, 27-26 Kentucky. UK led 31-26 at the break. Hawkins with 12 first half points. Interesting, Garcia and Dean, the two big guns for Louisville, held scoreless in the first half. So here we are at halftime, and I understand, is it true that Rick Pitino is at the podium right now? We have Rick Pitino at the podium for post-game reaction. Second half highlights right after this. Let's go hear from Rick Pitino right now.
Most hostile crowd you're going to face. And then the fourth thing is it's a revenge game. I said, now, if you can overcome those four, this will be the greatest wins of your life. And the fifth thing we added is, in the locker room afterwards, when you're down, and they're putting that type of heat on you, and things aren't going well, and you respond with that character, that's truly an unbelievable performance by a basketball team. We've got great respect for their ball club. We prepared our asses for them because of our respect. They're a hell of a ball club. And this is a special, special moment. You hate to see friends lose, because Tubby's not only an unbelievable coach, but he's a good friend. one of the classiest guys in the game. And we did it on a night where Francisco and Taekwon didn't have good nights due to their defense. And I got all over both of those guys at halftime saying, that man in the other locker room is a great coach. He's not letting you guys get off. So you got to make plays for other people. And you got to understand scouting. Their whole game plan is stop Garcia and Dean. And I said, the final moment is going to be which defense is better. Because we're having trouble scoring, we've got to go back to where they're having trouble scoring. So the best defensive team, and we haven't been a good rebounding team, and we knew that the only way we could win this game was to rebound with them.
And we're going to see dribble penetration. D'Artez shot Kentucky by going around our Kent game, beating everybody in their way.
I think they're in the same shape that we are. They use more plays. I just think we played great defense. They're a great basketball team. I think this is the best Kentucky team I've seen. You know, the only thing they don't have from last year is the shot blocking, but they've all gotten so much better. Fitch, Daniels, Hayes, but we played great post defense. We pressed intelligently. We're not giving any runouts. I think they had three fast breaks in the first half, and that's where Kentucky's great. They're unbelievable in transition. So they're a great basketball team. We had that special moment that happens, once in your lifetime. Well, Jerry, I told them that they're no longer a erratic shooting team. They're a very good shooting team. And then Hayes and Daniels he's got some Bernard King moves where he shoots it before you're ready. And I told some of the coaches that they remind me of Wicks Rowe from UCLA. They're that good a tandem. But we said if we can get to them while the ball is in the air, which means you have to know their play, we can trap them. If we get there when the man receives it, they're going to find the open man. And we did a great job, especially Otis George, of really seeing it.
Garcia and O'Bannon on the floor.
I think the two most overrated things in college basketball today are size and lack of bench. Because, you know, you look at all the great teams, Duke, Arizona, Connecticut, he plays only eight, North Carolina. You know, they've got so good play. Now, what we have to do is we can't let them be fresh at the end of the game. We have no chance of winning. So we have got to just wear them out, and try to play good defense down the stretch, and we did. So they're a great basketball team that just lost tonight. And we were very fortunate to win, played very hard, and I'm real proud of our kids.
That is UofL basketball head coach Rick Pitino reacting moments after Louisville's upset win over Kentucky, the final 65-56. Coming up in a couple of minutes, we're going to have second half highlights as well as live post-game reaction from Kentucky basketball head coach Tubby Smith. Right now, we're headed for break. Back in 2 minutes right here on the road to the Final Four, the Battle of the Bluegrass right here on News Channel 32 Sports. Welcome back to our live post-game coverage of the Battle of the Bluegrass, where just a few moments ago, Louisville upset Kentucky, the final 65-56. Now, we just showed you in the previous break highlights of the first half, as well as live coverage of Louisville basketball head coach Rick Pitino's press conference. Now, let's show you second half highlights and show you how this game wrapped up. We go back to the videotape and pick it up with Kentucky still trying to hang on to its lead. It led at halftime 31-26, and then here they are in the second half. Joe Fitch's three made it 36-28. And then Azubuike began firing it up again, a three for the Wildcats, and Azubuike 39-30, Kentucky in front. But Louisville did not quit. Conditioning was a huge factor. The big men a huge factor. Muhammad with the dunk from Luke Whitehead, 41-38. Louisville was within three of Kentucky's lead. And then it was the really big guys. Otis George with an old-fashioned three-point play tied the game at 41 halfway through the second frame. Now it was anybody's game, and George continued to be a dominant player. Amazingly, he led all scorers, believe it or not, with 13 points. George with the dunk, 43-41. UofL with its first lead of the game. And finally, after being shut out in the first half, Louisville's leading scorer, Francisco Garcia, dogged by the Kentucky defense all day, finally got it going with a three, 46-41. UofL in front. The Cardinals went on to win it, the final 65-56. Louisville upsets Kentucky, another number one, bites the dust. We just got final statistics a few moments ago, and I'm going to read them right from the form here. Again, Otis George, the shocking overall leading scorer with 13 points. Also, Luke Whitehead with 11 for the Cardinals. Francisco Garcia with 10. Larry O'Bannon with a great game. The male graduate with 11 points. For Kentucky, it was Kalina Azubuki with 12. Hawkins had 12, all in the first half on 4 3-pointers. Again, the final score is 65-56, Louisville over Kentucky. There's a lot to talk about. A lot have happened. Allison Gardner joins me. Allison, it was so much fun being here. I mean, talk about a larger-than-life event. The emotions were flying. It showed to the players. It showed with the fans.
It sure did. I mean, I haven't played basketball since middle school competitively, but I got to tell you, this had to be one of the toughest places in the country for the University of Louisville Cardinals to come in and play today. The crowd was on fire, and they were gunning for the UofL players and the coach, but these Cardinals came in here, and they never flinched, and the Cards walk away with bragging rights for the new year.
On the Saturday after Christmas, it wasn't Santa who showed up at Rupp Arena wearing red. The reception inside for the former University of Kentucky coach. To be kind, it was a little chilly.
He could have went to any other school other than U of L.
I hate Rick Pitino, and he coaches Louisville, so I just have to hate the whole team. It's just, there's just no excuse. I have to hate them all.
I have a different perspective. As a U of L fan, I booed him when he was at Kentucky, okay? But now he's on U of L's side, so I cheer for him, you know? So I can see why they're upset, but, they have a good coach of their own right, so we're happy to have him.
The atmosphere inside Rupp was electric for the in-state rivalry game. Some fans call it the biggest game of the year.
This is what I want. Yeah, Patino walked on water when he was here. We were trying to look, send a message, so.
I hope we're going to come home a winner.
The crowd was mostly blue with a couple of Cards sprinkled in.
I think it would be a huge win, but if things don't work out, it's not the end of the world.
But fans say the only number that really matters in the end is the final score.
It means everything. It's just having the opportunity, you know, to say that you beat Louisville, you know, that carries all the way until this time next year.
And, of course, you'll remember that the University of Louisville Cardinals handed Kentucky its last regular season loss 364 days ago today. And now the University of Kentucky fans are only hoping that this will mean the same thing that it meant last year, Fred, that these University of Kentucky Wildcats can go on another roll, but they do lose the number one ranking. And we'll have to see what kind of guts this team has and if they can rebuild from here.
Absolutely. It's tough being number one these days in college basketball.
Parity is big time.
Very tough.
Allison Gardner, thank you very much. Good
My
job.
Pleasure.
All right.